When you walk on the ground, it seems very hard and stable. However, our planet is constantly moving. It orbits the Sun, rotates on its axis, and the ground we walk on also moves. Let's find out more about it today. To begin with, the Earth has not always looked the way it does today. About 300 million years ago, it didn't have the seven continents, but instead one massive supercontinent called Pangea. About 200 million years ago, Pangea split into Laurasia and Gondwana. Subsequently, they also continued to break into several smaller land masses, and gradually, all of them slowly moved to their current positions. This idea of continental drift was proposed by the German scientist Alfred Wegener in 1912 and was called the theory of continental drift. According to Wegener, the main proof of his theory lay in the fact that if you look at geographical maps, the coastlines of South America and Africa can be fitted together like pieces of a jigsaw puzzle. Incidentally, some scientists had noticed this feature of the coastline's contours long before him. However, Wegener also pointed to the fossils of the same species of animals and plants on different continents. They simply would not have been able to travel across the oceans. He also pointed out numerous similarities in the geological structure of the continents. But Wegener could not offer an exhaustive account of why exactly Pangea broke up. Therefore, later, the theory of continental drift was replaced by the theory of plate tectonics. It sounds complicated and super scientific, but it's actually quite simple. Our planet is composed of four distinct layers: the crust, the mantle, the outer core, and the inner core. The crust and the upper layer of the mantle form the lithosphere, the Earth's rigid outer shell. This solid rocky layer is broken up into large pieces called tectonic plates. The plates have highly irregular shapes of varying thickness and size, but together they do fit together like a jigsaw puzzle. There are seven major plates: Pacific, North American and South American, Eurasian, African, Antarctic, and Indo-Australian. There are also numerous smaller, minor plates and dozens of microplates. As you can see, these plates include continents and adjacent parts of the oceans. Beneath the lithosphere is a fluid layer of molten rock called the asthenosphere. Why is it fluid? Because powerful forces are at work in the bowels of the Earth, causing thermal convection in the mantle. Let's take a pot of soup and turn on the gas. From below, the soup heats up and rises, whereas on the surface it cools down and settles down again. A similar process governs the mantle. Moreover, it goes on continuously, which is why the tectonic plates slide over the mantle layer. This is the main point of the theory of plate tectonics. In other words, it's not the continents that drift around the Earth's surface, as Wegener assumed, but the tectonic plates covering the entire Earth move along the asthenosphere. Since all the plates are tightly adjacent to each other, the movement of any of them affects the surrounding plates, causing them to gradually move. They can move towards each other. There are three options here. The first option is a collision of two continental plates. Because both plates are the same density, neither can sink beneath the other. Therefore, they bend and deform, thereby forming mountains. For example, the collision of the Indian and Eurasian plates formed the Himalayas 50 million years ago. Incidentally, these two tectonic plates are still colliding, which is why the Himalayas continue to grow a few millimeters each year. The second option is the collision of a continental plate with an oceanic one. The heavier oceanic plate sinks below the lighter continental plate, reaching the mantle and melting into magma. Magma rises and erupts, creating volcanoes. The third option is the collision of two oceanic plates. One oceanic plate is eventually subducted under the other, and in the process, a very deep trench is formed. This is a long, narrow, and very deep depression in the ocean floor. For example, the Mariana Trench, the deepest place on Earth, was formed by the convergence of the mighty Pacific and smaller Philippine plates. Alternatively, plates can move away from each other. This creates a gap, which gradually grows to be a huge split, and allows magma to rise to the surface. The magma solidifies, forming a new crust at the edges of the plates. As a result, mountain ranges are formed underwater. For example, the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, located along the floor of the Atlantic Ocean. And on land, rifts are formed, large faults in the Earth's crust, like the Great Rift Valley in Africa, for instance. If the plates there continue to drift apart, this could cause Africa to split in two over the course of tens of millions of years. The final way of plate shifting is a transform fault, where two plates slide past one another in opposite directions at different speeds. Due to friction, tension is created, which builds up and an earthquake occurs. The continents are still moving today, really very slowly. So slowly that no one on Earth can feel it. Just a few centimeters every year. Your nails grow at about the same rate. Scientists believe that the continents will reunite again in the distant future. At that point, most of the world's landmass will be joined into a supercontinent called Pangea Ultima. The theory of plate tectonics is one of the most important theories in the history of Earth science, because it provides insights into the causes of earthquakes, volcanoes, and the ever-changing surface of our planet. Now you know about this theory. Thanks for watching. See you next time.